Hi, I'm Ramon Fernando, UQ penultimate undergrad, here to talk about tidal bores. So, first question. Tidal bores are a remarkable phenomenon, and given their rarity, people around the world make sure to take advantage of them, whether it be for surfing, experimenting, or tourism. The awesomely named Silver Dragon of the Xiangtang River in China is the biggest, most famous, and most spectacled tidal bore in the world. The aim of this investigation was to undergo physical modeling of a tidal bore in a channel that better reflected field channels. A range of free surface profiles were quantified by varying the gate opening at bore generation. This was done to better model throughout similitude by varying the celerity of the incoming bore. All free surface profiles generally showed some degree of undulating motion. Asymmetry between the shallow and deep sections was clearly identified, where the amplitude decreased with flow depth. The initial roll-off was also highly energetic, and displayed wave properties different from the undulations afterwards. In steady flow, VX dominates, whilst VY and VZ approach zero. As the bore arrives, VX decreases sharply and the other velocities increase. The introduction of negative velocities is an indicator of recirculation. As expected from streamline theory, VX and VZ are at affairs to each other. VY has generally been the unknown. In the unsteady state, VY exhibits quite an interesting behavior near the base, where the recirculation zone grows, shrinks, and moves with the free surface. Superimposing the velocity fields together, some pretty clear zones have been outlined, which can be modeled better if we look at the vector field. Total velocity is comprised of a mean and fluctuating component. The fluctuating component is what drives momentum exchange and mixing. Looking at an infinitesimal particle, there are three normal and three tangential shear forces. These shear forces are a cross product of velocity fluctuations. Of the six stresses, stresses related to the longitudinal direction dominated, as to be physically expected. The impacted zone of Reynolds stresses increased significantly with the bore's arrival. So, in conclusion, a slope bed changes the tidal bore's effects significantly. Whilst being rare phenomenons, tidal bores are and will continue to be important in hydraulic design. We just need to figure out how they work.